Roy, Zoe Rivers Incorporated. This is my new company. $1 shares, I bought 100. And this is the beginning of Zoe River. It goes through this beautiful red clay and collects minerals. That's the sandstone that Uluru is made out of. The pink sandstone from the inland sea. It got pushed to the surface. And these are my birds. These are what the Europeans called noisy miners. Not very noisy, are they? They're scared of them. Not surprisingly, compared for what they did to them, is to take them down into the mines to see if they died from poison gas, like canaries. They did worse than that. They hunted them for pleasure, the pure pleasure of killing them. To shut them up. That's the alarm call. Been repeated by a crow. The alarm of the aeroplane. That bird there. It looks like a crow to the untrained eye, but it's a rainforest bird called a currawong. And that one over there is bathing itself in the pond. It's a young crow. Its eyes haven't turned white yet. It's getting its plumage out. The crows take the bread from here. And they place it in the water. They place it in the water and then they feed on it. There's proof. Look at that. That's a treasure. Children love them. Feathers. Everyone loves feathers. They're beautiful. This is the Hana Ganga, the Hana River. This is the Hana River. It's flowing very, very gently. And I'm using black ant power Placant energy. And Hannah River starts over here. It's very complicated. This is the Gondwana geoengineering. As you can see, only a little trickle of water. I'm being very prudent and frugal with the water use. Unlike the people who do fracking. Yeah, and I use every drop. And DRBS is Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary. And I'm breeding frogs. And I'm growing gotukola. Two leaves a day prevents and cures diabetes. Two leaves a day cures diabetes. And this is got healing milk, which you get just by peeling that off. And you rub it on your cuts, like that. And it'll be healed in a day or two. Yeah. And it also works against fungal infections, like I have between my toes from the hospitals and cuts from my shoes. Yeah, that's why it's a sacred plant to Buddhists, because it's healing. Now this is, these birds were nesting in the roof of the house when I first moved in here 8 years ago. But there were only a few of them. Now the whole family is united. They've come to Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary. And they like me. They like me and I like them. And I had a flock of 70 parrots, but then they locked me up, and when I came out there were only about 10. I don't know whether they poached them or whether they just moved on to greener pastures because I wasn't feeding them. But they do poach them, these birds, these beautiful birds. Not the noisy miners. They just shoot them. But the parrots, they're worth a lot of money. So they were Miller. This fellow over here, he had an operation going, which he had to stop because of me, which is why he hates me so much. He was packing the birds into plywood boxes and shipping them overseas to the Polish mafia, or Brodsky family, the Brodsky gang. And Miller also had pipes run underneath here to steal my runoff water. Here's a pipe that runs from here directly underneath his house. And he's stealing my sewerage as well. He works for a gas and electricity company, works for a gas company. And he wired up my hot water to explode. I don't have hot water anymore. This is just my evidence. I can turn it off. There, the spark went, but it doesn't work. Then this over here, the pond drains through to the pond that's collecting underneath the house. No, it's not flowing in there, it's going underground. And initially, when this hill's hoist was rickety, now it's rock solid. And it was rattling around, so it's hollow underneath here. So there's things buried. I don't know what treasures are buried, or what skeletons or remains. And the other pipe that Miller ran is one over here that you can see. This is what he's objecting to. When I was locked up, they re-collected all of this and made sure that I can't lift the manhole up, because there is one pipe that runs down like this, which is carrying my inside water, and there's another pipe that goes that way directly under Miller's property. So there's my evidence for hub forensics. And the other spy on the other side worked for the Air Force, and he uses the old traditional rooftop spying method. And he's got a Motorola. The Motorola was bought by Google, which is good news. And he's got a old solar panel on the roof of his house. And he's gutted the whole house and built underneath it. And his son is a fellow who was, you can't see it because he built a fence so that I couldn't see in where his son had bird nests, bird cages rather. He was stealing parrots as well. They were stealing parrots. That is a currawong. That's a young currawong. A rainforest bird, and its eye hasn't turned fully yellow yet. He got alarmed by me because they're vulnerable when they're wet. Yeah, there's another caravan. They were looking very unhealthy a few weeks ago, but they're looking a lot better. Their feathers, you can tell birds by their feathers, their plumage. See, he's a bit weathered, a bit moth-eaten. When I run the water, that's all they need. Water and bread. Bread and water. It's a basic necessity for life. And it should be provided free. Bread and water. I provide it free to my birds. Which is why this bird came and spent its last night with me. And then crawled underneath my house to die. So thank you for watching Dr. Romesh's Bird Sanctuary.